guys, I'm Priyanka and welcome back to my channel. I hope you all are doing good. So in this video, I'm going to share my honest opinion and my review and my experience about this MAC Pro Conceal and Correct Palette. So this is basically a concealer palette by MAC, and you get 6 different shades of concealer in which it includes like a light shade, deep shade, orange, yellows. So all of these shades have their own features, own work. Like, you can use all of these shades in a different way to contour your face as a deepest shade. Orange shade concealer, you can use it to hide any pigmentation, imperfection on your face, some cut marks, anything you can hide with the orange shade. And yellow shade you can use to highlight your face. Now again, you get a 4 different shade of concealer, light to medium and in deep shade. So the deepest one you can use to contour your face, and lightest shade and all you can mix and match and use it as your concealers to hide your dark circle, shadows under your face, or any of the blemishes, imperfection, marks, anything. You can do a magic with this palette. I'm in the shade medium deep. Like, you get this concealer palette in 3 different shades. So one is the light shade, one you get the darker than this one, and this is something in between, like a medium shade, this shade. And I tried over there, and what I personally feel that this shade is very versatile. Like, it can go very beautifully with Indian skin tone. And Indian skin tone, by which I mean like from dusky to a light shade, you can go ahead and work with this palette. All you need to do is you have to learn a little bit technique how to blend it. If you are light, you can go with less quantity of the product, of course. And if you have dusky skin or you have deep medium skin color, then you can go ahead with more quantity of product. And so many things is there. That's what I'm gonna give you a quick tutorial, and like how I use this palette on my regular daily basis to do my own makeup. So this palette retails for 3,700 rupees. Yes, you get 6 different shades and 6 gram of total quantity of product from 3,700, and of course it is by MAC, so you can expect the price a little bit. And I can tell you that it is one of the most expensive product by MAC, especially if you come with the base like foundation and concealer and all. So you can purchase this palette from any of the MAC cosmetic stores, and MAC always give free trials on all of their products, so it's better you can go ahead and try over there. If you like this palette, you can go for it. And you can also purchase this online. Like, you can purchase it from Myntra Beauty, from shopperstop.com. Also on Nykaa it is available, so you can purchase this online. Anyway, MAC never gives any discount on any of their products, so you will have to pay same price wherever you purchase it, online or offline. So it's totally up to you. So now I'm going to tell you how I use my MAC concealer palette to do my makeup on a regular basis, so that you can get a little bit idea how you can work with this palette. So I like to use these 2 light shades as my concealer. I like to mix these 2 shades and tap it under my eye area. So I'm going to show you how I do it. I like to work with my fingers, because the warmth of the finger helps you to blend this product easily on your under eye area or wherever you apply, because it's super blendable. So you don't need to be like very particular about any brushes. You can even work with your fingertip. Okay, so I'm just going to take a little bit of these 2 concealer. I like to mix both of these 2 shades, and I'm going to quickly tap it under my eye area like so. So you can see here, you get that exact high coverage, and so you don't need to take a lot of product at one go, and it kind of conceals your imperfections or dark circles or shadows under your eye area. Like, I don't have a lot of dark circles, but still you can see the difference between both the eyes. And I'm going to do this side, and then I'm going to show you how I use the rest of the shades on my face. So I'm quickly going to mix these 2 shades like 2 times on swatch max, and I'll tap it under my eye area. So right now I don't have anything on my face except my moisturizer, if you can see here. Most of the time I like to use my concealer even after my foundation, but today I'm using it before. Like, it's up to my mood, whenever what I feel like is easy for me or works for me. And now coming to this orange shade, which is also called as the color correction shade. So you can use this orange shade of concealer to neutralize your pigmentation on your face, like you have any discoloration somewhere, light skin, somewhere dark skin, which is called as pigmentation. So you can use this shade to neutralize it, to minimize the effect of that color. And on the top of this orange color correction, you can go ahead with some concealer and foundation to blend all of that and achieve that kind of flawless look. So I personally don't have like a lot of pigmentation on my face or a lot of dark, heavy dark circles, but still I like to use this orange color corrections whenever I'm more tired, or I like sometimes I get dark circles, or if I'm traveling and then I have to get ready for a party or some event. In that way, if I need a really high coverage and a flawless base, then I use my color correction, this shade. You can also use this shade on any of your other body part as well. Like you can use this shade on your knees if you have any pigmentation going on your knees and all. You can just tap a little bit of orange color correction that will hide that darkness of the knees, and on the top of that you can straight away go ahead with some foundation and you're good to go. Or if you're wearing short dresses or you have any cut mark on your body, you can use this orange color correction. So in that way it is really helpful. So I think you must have at least one orange color correction set in your vanity. I'm just going to use it right around my mouth a little bit to hide some pigmentation. So you just need to take a very little of that on your fingertip, or you can use any of your concealer brush for that. And just go around a little bit wherever you feel like you have pigmentation, like discoloration on your skin. I feel I have a little bit here, and I think I have here a little bit. So it may appear you look like the orangish shade, but again I'm gonna go with my concealer which I used right before on the top of it to neutralize the orange shade and to achieve that flawless base. So I'm going to show you how I work. So now I'm going to take again the two of these lightest shades concealer which I used earlier, and this time I'm going to use my concealer brush because I need a little bit more quantity of it, and I have to cover up this orangish shade on my around my mouth like so. If you conceal the area around your lips, then it will pop up your lips like whenever you wear any lipstick, and also shows the actual size of your lips. Basically, it will pop up the actual size of your lips and make your lips appear fuller and thick. And so using this orange concealer, you can also hide any pigmentation on your lips, around your lips, like you have some dark skin or any dead skin, you can hide it using the orange color correction. All you need to know the flow, how you can work it, and it comes through the practice. So this is how you can see my skin here. It appears more bright, and once I'm going to go ahead with a lot more foundation on the top of it, you will get a really natural finish. So this is how I use orange shade. Also, thus in case if you work by mistakenly, if you take a lot more orange color correction, you apply it on your face, then in that way you can just neutralize the shade of orangeness by mixing with few light shade of the concealer. That's how we call it mix and match to manage your makeover. So yeah, this is how you can work. So you don't have to worry about, you just go ahead and apply some light shade concealer on the top of your orange shade. So now I'm going to show you how I use my yellow concealer, and after that I'm going to tell you how I use these two dark shade concealer, but the flow of the makeup will be different. Like after doing my concealer, I'm just going to go ahead with my foundation, and then I like to highlight my face and contour my face. So I'll be quickly back after doing my foundation. So I'm going to do my foundation, and you don't need to be very perfect in blending out your concealer, because anyway after putting your foundation on the top of your concealer, you have to blend it nicely. So this is how I generally do my makeup. If you want to know more detail about this foundation, you can go ahead and watch my review video on the foundation. So as you can see, I don't have any dark circle or any pigmentation around my mouth right now. And now I'm going to show you how I use the highlighting and contouring shade from this palette. So firstly, I'm going to highlight my face. So you can use this yellow shade under your foundation, and you can achieve that yellow undertone wala foundation. Because sometimes it is very hard to find yellow undertone foundation which has a yellowish texture. in most of the brands. So you can achieve that kind of look if you want. Occasionally you can go for that. And then you can use this shade also to highlight your face. Basically, I personally used to highlight all the center parts of my face, and highlighting and all, I like to work with my brush because you get a better control wherever you have to highlight your face. So I'm just gonna go bridge of my nose on my center part of my forehead. I also like to wear this light shade foundation on my eyelid. It gives a really nice base for my eyeshadow because it's a light color. So whenever you work with light shade on the eyelid, it creates a nice white base for your makeup, like eyeshadow, and your eyeshadow will appear beautifully, like the colors will reflect more if you have really nice bright base underneath your eyeshadow. So that's how I like to use the highlighting shade. I also use a little bit under my eyes just to highlight my under eye area. So you can skip out this step if you don't want on a regular basis, but again, if you want all that foundation routine and concealer routine you follow, then you can go ahead with this step. So this will quickly highlight the under eye area as well. So you can use any damp beauty blender and just damp it. So you can see here, I'm done with my highlighting, concealer and my foundation. Now I'm going to contour my face a little bit and I'm going to show you how I usually contour my face. So we have two contouring shades. So I like to use the lightest shade on regular general basis, and when I need like a heavy contouring, then I like to prefer the deeper shade. And sometimes I prefer to just mix both of these two shades and then use it as my contouring. Again, these shades are nicely pigmented, like you don't need to work with a lot of product. So as you saw how I did my contouring, like it gives you a very, very natural finesse, as you can see here. So I'm going to set all my full face with some compact and then do my makeup and get back to you guys. So guys, as you can see here, I'm done my full face makeup, and this is how my face looks after doing it. I did a kind of glam makeup a little bit, but again, it's not important that you have to always use MAC foundation only along with this concealer. You can go ahead with any of your favorite brand foundation, and I think it works really well with different foundations, because I have tried on even with my BB cream, my Maybelline foundation, L'Oreal foundation, so it really works well, like just like as a concealer. So girls, if you will go with my personal suggestion, I will recommend this palette to all of those who know the mix and match technique a little bit at a pro level, then you can use this palette. Of course, it is not too tough to handle it, but again, if you are if you know more about how to mix and match all of these shades, then you will be able to play a lot with this palette and utilize all of these colors. And I will not recommend this palette to all of those who are not more into the makeup, who don't do their own makeup by itself. Then in that way, I think you won't be able to use all of these 6 shades, and investing 3,700 rupees won't work for you, of course. In that way, you can go with any individual shades of concealer in the MAC, and of course that will be quite affordable if you compare it with this palette. And of course in future, I will love to invest in this palette, because this palette is everything, like it's a magic if you really want to achieve a beautiful base for your makeup, and a lot more makeup artists use this palette. Of course, if you are looking to invest in a really good base for your makeup, then this, you can go for this palette. You will love this one, of course. So I will recommend this palette to all of the skin type. If you have oily skin or a combination or a dry skin, you can go with this concealer palette. It will suit you guys. And yes guys, so this is all about my honest opinion and experience, what I think, what I feel about MAC Pro Conceal and Correct palette after using it. Also, if I miss anything to inform in this video, then of course I will link all the details in the description box as always, so don't forget to check out the description box below. I hope this video was helpful for you guys. If yes, then please like this video and comment below and let me know what you guys think about this video. If you have any queries related to this video or any of my videos on YouTube, Then girls, please feel free to comment below and also subscribe to my channel to stay updated with all of the upcoming videos like this. And you can also follow me on all of my social medias, my Instagram, Twitter and Facebook, so that we can always stay connected. And yes girls, I will see you soon in my next video. Till then, take care. Bye.